that's me.
Well, I'm on the radio. Really? Now? Oh. Funny one, Chris. Yeah. Okay. Right, three questions. Yes? It's a type of sheep, isn't it? Oh. Yeah. Suck it out. Yes!
Very well done, Gary. And finally, for £5,000...
Shh! I'm on the radio!
Are you nervous?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay, Gary. What's orange and can't get through a revolving door? I'm gonna have to hurry you, Gary. And the answer is Judith Chalmers with a spear in her face.
Goodbye.
No, I hate practical jokes, don't you?
Not at all. Mainstay of British humour.
You don't seem to go to work much.
Oh, we're pretty laid back about that in the music biz.
Yeah, you must be to get away with a shirt like that.
What's this say?
Greek for puff shirt, is it?
Kevin's bar and Bazooki Repair Centre, Mykonos. Went there last year.
No, I often wish I'd gone in for something a bit more glamorous, like the music business. You don't get to snog banana armour selling burglar alarms, I can tell you. What exactly does a record company executive do, then?
Oh, you know, customer interfacing, looking at the market. Sometimes get to schmooze some artists.
Oh, schmooze, eh? I've asked Dorothy, but she says you feel dirty afterwards.
No, it means talk to.
Oh, yeah, of course. Still, I bet you managed to slip the odd backing singer a few inches every now and again, eh?
No. Mind you, one of the village people once gave me his phone number.
I was sort of hoping that maybe you could introduce me to some of the women that you work with.
I work with guys mainly.
Oh.
Hello, big boy sauna club. I'm afraid there's nobody here.
Oh, sorry, mummy.
Daring fellow like Van Gogh, laterally.
Creosote nipples sadness.
Eh?
If you can talk cobblers, George, so can I.
No, it's a crossword clue. I've only got two to get.
I've never seen the point in crosswords.
Well, you have to fill in all the little squares with
letters. I know all that. I've just got something better to do with my time.
So I see.
That's educational. 20 things you never knew about panties. Hey, don't get that sort of info in The Independent, do you?
Is that a typical page?
Television, sex, severed limbs, royal family, sex, yes, pretty typical.
Colin Peabody, flamboyantly dressed presenter of Get Out of Bed Britain, recently holidayed with two male companions in gay love paradise Mykonos.
Oh, my new flatmate Tony had a holiday in Mykonos.
I wonder if he went with Colin Peabody. Mind you, Colin's already got a lot of young friends. I always think Thermos sounds like a Greek island, don't you?
Bloke from the village people gave me his phone number once. I work with guys mainly.
Big boy sauna club. Sauna club. Big boy sauna club. Sauna club.
Gary, are you all right?
Oh, yes. Perfectly. I just found out I'm living with a homosexual. Nothing alarming.
I don't think that matters, does it?
Not a bit. Whoopee.
My nephew's gay. He told us last year during the Top of the Pops Christmas special.
Oh, smashing. Maybe the three of us should get together and open an antique shop.
Some people think that you're a bit old to be living with another man.
I'm not living with another man. He's there to pay the rent.
Oh, I see. A rent boy.
Maybe you chose a man because you've got suppressed urges.
There's nothing wrong with my urges, mate. Last night I dreamt I was strip searching Sue Lawley. Huh? Completely normal.
I've often wondered what it'd be like to sleep with a man.
George, it's awful. You see, first of all...
No, Anthea.
I'd have to give him Marjorie's side of the bed. My reading light's got an awkward switch.
Look, can we talk about something sensible, please?
Pygmy's pine for slang bulldozer.
That's better.
Playing the guitar?
Yeah. Do you want to come and listen?
No. I was thinking of cutting your hands off.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's this headache.
How'd you get that, then?
I've no idea.
Come in. Have you, ever played the bass guitar before?
No. Have you?
Lesson number one.
Well, what makes you think I want to learn?
Handy through the holy. Now, some technical things first, right? Now, these are the strings. And that's the cable. Now, you get some coming curly, some coming straight. This one's straight.
Cable, strings, I'm with you so far, yeah? Mm-hmm.
And this is the neck. Some people are surprised how long this is. And down here is where you get all the naughty high notes. And down here is where you get all the floppy, juicy notes. Well, that's the basics over with, anyway. I'm glad you've come down.
So am I.
I wondered if you could sew a patch on my jeans.
You've got to be joking.
Why? Oh, can't you sew?
Men assume that women enjoy sewing.
Well, I do it myself, only they never seem to come out smart, you know.
Where are they? Just this once.
Oh, great. Look, if there's anything I can do, just say the word.
Well, actually, you can tear that down. I hate that sort of thing.
Oh, no, that's all right, you see. I picked that up in Dusseldorf. It's, ironic. Yeah, she's campaigning for sexual rights.
What does it say?
We want sexual rights. And we want it now.
You speak German?
Oh, aber, Beckenbauer.
Well, actually, there is something you can do for me.
Sure.
I've got a letter needs translating.
No problem.
I'll bring it down tomorrow. Wait, you haven't thought of playing a different instrument, have you?
Yeah, I have, actually. This.
I got one.
What is it? Super vixens.
Hey.
Love in a women's prison. Their only crime was to have their needs.
It's a serious study of repressed sexuality in a pressure cooker environment.
It's mindless, exploitative tact, Gary.
Shall we get it out, then?
No!
I see. I'm supposed to apologise, am I, for being a perfectly normal heterosexual who happens to find women attractive? Well, pardon me.
Look, I don't mind seeing a film with sex in it. It's you that wanted to get out the best of Flipper last week.
That's a classic.
Not the third time. Last week, I had to listen to you sobbing through E.T.
Sobbing?
And tonight, you come on all macho, trying to get me to arm wrestle with you.
Yeah, well, you started before I was ready, actually.
And now you're pretending to be some sort of sex maniac. What is the matter with you?
It's Tony. He's,
What?
He's a homo.
A homeowner?
He's gay.
Oh, quick, fumigate the furniture.
Right, look, I've got nothing against homosexualism in its proper place.
And where do you stand on bigotry?
I see, I suppose you'd be delighted, would you, to come home and find your flatmate's a lesbian?
Look, you weren't so homophobic 2 minutes ago when you wanted us to watch sex slave jail women.
Love in a women's prison, and that's different. They're women, for God's sake. I ask you, why do people have to peddle this kind of smut? Disgusting.
Anyway, what makes you think that Tony's gay?
Well, he's hardly conducting a meaningful sexual relationship with a woman, is he?
Neither are you.
At least there's no question about my sexuality.
Oh, yes, I'm so sorry. The man with the live animal down his trousers.
Look, the other day, I asked him, just conversationally, like, about the women in his office. And he went all funny.
Well, he's probably never seen you with your tongue hanging out.
He's got girly hair. And he holidays in gay love paradise Mykonos.
Well, if it bothers you so much, why don't you just ask him?
Because it doesn't bother me.
It does.
It doesn't.
I thought you liked him.
I do. I just won't be happy until he's out of my flat, that's all.
Enjoy it. Here, I reckon they made a mistake here. 12 across, 5 letters, God. That's got to be Jesus, right?
They're not the same thing, though, are they?
Yeah, Jesus is the same as God, isn't he? Bit younger.
What about Allah?
Nah, that's going to put me dung and me foreskin out of whack.
You sure about this, Nev?
I've been doing this crossword for 2 weeks. You ain't going to tell me I'm not on top of it by now, are you?
Hey, Nev, you ever been to Germany?
Yeah, I toured there with Black Sabbath, actually.
Oh, great days, eh?
Yeah, oh, the camaraderie. I could tell you a few stories, I tell you.
Yeah, I bet, mate.
The band had this nickname for me.
Yeah? What?
Neville, the lazy bastard roadie.
You didn't pick up any German while you were out there, did you?
No, I was only there a couple of weeks. Got sacked for having sex with a groupie.
I thought that's what they were for.
Yeah, I was driving the van at the time. Left the longest skid marks in Bavaria, according to the policeman guy.
Listen, Nev, I told the girl upstairs that I'd translate this letter for her, and the only German I can remember is, please come to bed with me.
Nice to see this neighbour.
Oh. Yeah, gorgeous, mate. Yeah, just lit with a boyfriend.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's like going in a pub and finding a cigarette packet. And
yeah?
Still got fags in it.
Yeah.
Hello? Tony. Of course it's my phone. Hang on a second. Nev, this phone you sold me, it was yours, wasn't it?
No, I found it down Mr. Byright. What do you expect for 10 quid?
Yeah. Gary! Hiya.
Hi.
And Nev, this is Gary. Hi. He's the bloke who owns the flat I live in.
I've got just the thing you want, mate. Nice mobile phone.
Not now, Nev.
Oh, I happen to have a couple of hours on my hand. Thought I'd come and catch you at work.
Well, what do you think? Great, eh?
This is it, is it?
Yeah.
This is the glittering epicentre of your business empire, is it?
More of a store, really.
Where do you meet your clients?
Well, I normally stand about here, and they normally stand where you are.
And if it's Michael Jackson, they normally go down a kebab place on the corner.
You told me you were a record company executive.
Well, you seem to be looking for a management type.
Yeah, look what I got, a geek with a jumble sale.
Don't be such a bloody snob.
You told me you had a secretary. Well, she had to go to look after her
dogs.
Baby.
Babies. Baby dogs.
I've been down the travel agent.
Oh, you're going away?
Yes, I was thinking of going to Mykonos, actually. What's it like?
Well, I don't know, really. I didn't get about very much.
Oh, yes. Plenty of secluded bays, are there?
Secluded bays, yeah. They got them, yeah.
Did your girlfriend like it?
Well, actually, I just went with a mate.
Oh, nice.
Are you going to go?
No.
Look, Gary, I hope this job mix-up isn't going to come between us.
Well, we'll see, shall we? Hello? Yeah, well, if you must know, I'm standing outside Tony Smart Records Limited in Bridge Road Market. What? No, I don't know who you are. Do you know who I am? Well, I'm not going to tell you, am I? So you won't know, will you? I'm on the phone! What? What's that got to do with you? Oh, I see, officer. All right, well, I'll see you when you get here. It was... I went to see Tony at work today. Turns out all he runs is a little tiny second-hand record store.
Oh, well. Bango's your idea of having the Nolan sisters round for Berth Borgin, you know?
I still haven't found out if he's a fat or not. Oh, well, I want somebody I can go to the pub with. Talk about women. Get drunk. Pick up a tandoori. Come back, watch the footy. Open the fridge, get out a can.
Oh, stop, please. So depressing.
Now I've found out I'm sharing a flat with Pillow Biter Man.
Gary, shut up.
Well, it's not normal, is it?
Normal? After your suggestion last night that we experiment with whipped cream.
I was joking.
You bought 6 cans of it. Look, just ask him straight out and shut up.
Hiya.
Hello.
Hi, Tony.
I found this. I thought I'd paint it up, make an attractive lamp.
Great.
You know, screw a bulb in the top, make it nice.
Tony, Gary wanted to ask you something.
No, I didn't.
What was it worrying you, Gary?
Nothing.
Was it something to do with sex? Would you like me to ask for you? Would you like that? Tony, Gary was wondering if you're gay.
Well, what I actually said was... did you see?
No, I'm not.
You had to embarrass me, didn't you? It's so irritating!
Hi. Hope I'm not interrupting anything.
No. Gary was just making a complete arse of himself, but he's finished.
I bought the letter. Is it okay?
Yeah. Hand it over. Hansen C. Erber.
Let's have a look then. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah.
Dear Deborah, who's it from?
A German. He ate in the restaurant all last week. We got on really well.
Oh, was he nice?
He was, actually. Sort of blonde with a really sensitive mouth.
He couldn't write in English, could he? That would have been too simple.
Okay. Dear Deborah, thank you for the affection you showed me. How is London? Those crazy red buses.
Jeez, I don't know about you. I worry about the European communities.
However, I thought I should write to say that I am...
a Nazi.
To say that I am already engaged to be married. Oh, I meant to tell you, but I forgot. Find a nice English boy. Best wishes, Herman. Oh, bad luck.
Herman the German.
I don't know what he's on about. We only spoke for half an hour.
Can I have a look? I did German A-level.
Dear Deborah, thank you for talking to me when I was lonely in London. Can I ask you a favour? My friend has a Morris Traveller car, which he is seeking the timber for, and which he cannot buy here in Berlin. Please send me some, and I will send you the money. Best wishes, Herman.
What did I say?
I don't know who's worse. Him for asking me to send him car parts, or you for being a pathetic, lying scumbag.
It's a tricky one, isn't it? Herman the German. No, no. She's got brilliant legs, trust me. Tapered, you know.
We've already got the legs.
Have we? Oh. Right. We'll have Michelle Pfeiffer up to the knee and a woman off the Special K advert up to the hip.
This is getting really complicated.
Well, we're going to be sharing a log cabin for, like, eternity. We might as well get the details right.
All right, let's recap. Mm. The face is a singer with a cute nose from the Bangles. Bottom, Kylie.
Obviously.
Alternating on a weekly basis with the Cuban sprinter in the leotard whose name we can't remember. I thought you'd gone to bed.
No. I was going to go home and then you two started discussing which beers turn your urine blue and I lost the will to live.
You're going to stay the night then?
Suppose I have to.
Night, Dorothy.
Aye.
Is there any chance of you two treating women like human beings one of these days?
Sorry. So what about people we know?
Woman in the chemist who doesn't wear a bra.
Great lips.
Oh, great, great lips.
And there's always Deborah, of course. Can you do that?